in week number three, we saw Rondell Moore be more involved in the game planning. In week number three against Dallas, 6 targets, 4 receptions, still only 8 yards is the problem. He's so close to the line of scrimmage. His average depth of target on the season is 3.5 yards. That's not going to get it done. And we really haven't seen Rondell Moore elevate his snaps. He hasn't exceeded 27 in any game. The last 2 games, weeks 2 and 3, only 22 pass snaps. And his PFF receiving grade is 56. That's really bad. So while we are encouraged by Rondell Moore getting involved, the underlying efficiency metrics and snap usage is concerning. Now, we also saw 3 rushing attempts as well from Rondell Moore in week number 3. So he's going to get 5 to 10 touches in a game. I think that's going to be pretty safe. But he's still just a role player and a gadget player, a part-time player. Rondell Moore is wide receiver 53 in fantasy points per game. And right now, he's wide receiver 62 in projected points. So I'm not looking to roll Rondell Moore out in my starting lineup. He's not a deep flex consideration. He's not someone that I'm going out and saying, you know what, I want to take a dart throw on Rondell Moore. Even if he spikes and has one big play, it's probably not worth it compared to other players like a KJ Osborne, who is playing majority of snaps and can get some big plays, but also a little bit of volume. So I would consider, for instance, KJ Osborne over Rondell Moore, not only in week 4, but moving forward until we see something else from Rondell Moore.